and welcome to CLU News. I'm Kira Chapman.
And I'm Courtney Nunes.
On tonight's show, we will look into the ending of a freshman tradition, the beginning of online classes, and the results of Mr. Kingsman Contest.
We will also cover the CLU Choir's recent tour, Kingsman Baseball, and senior Eric Rogers struts his stuff for NFL scouts. Also, we take a look at what students did for spring break.
We go to Heather, who has more on the story about the painting of the rocks.
I'm Heather Ford, and we are up here on Mount Clef, right above California Lutheran University. If you take a look to my left, you'll see the CLU rocks that have been used in the student freshman orientation tradition for many years. The tradition was that the students come up here with plans to paint the rocks, and then in the midst, a paint fight breaks out, starting all the fun. Well, rumors have been going around campus that the tradition is going to be stopped. And we spoke with Shaquila Todd, a junior, and the student orientation coordinator as to why they're going to stop this tradition, if a new tradition will take its place. And we also spoke with a couple students to find out their reactions.
Our biggest thing is that we're trying to increase the inclusivity of orientation and painting the rocks with our class growing. It's, you know, back when it started, we only had maybe, you know, like 400 students coming in. If we're racking up about 600, 700 students coming in at the incoming year, painting the rocks in that small little fence area isn't working.
Due to the growing sizes of the incoming freshman classes, the tradition became a safety hazard.
It also has a lot to do with safety hazards. If something were to happen up there, everybody would get trampled on trying to run back down that hill.
They were also concerned about people with disabilities not being able to participate in the activity. If someone couldn't make it up the hill, then they were left out, and it became unfair to those students.
Our whole idea of orientation is so it's a welcoming and inclusive environment, and with a whole group of students possibly not being able to make their way up the hill, it's not being inclusive to the incoming class.
Part of my freshman orientation, which I didn't go to all of it, but that was the best part, so I'm really bummed that they're getting rid of it.
I was like, oh my God, you're so covered in paint. Then, you know, as people just started talking, and actually I met my now roommate, who's been my roommate for 3 years now, walking down from Painting at the Rocks, and we've been friends ever since. It was a really great experience.
Student orientation coordinators are working together to create a new tradition that will be just as fun for the new classes to participate in. They don't plan on telling anyone what the new tradition will be until it has been completely thought through.
Like I said, we're trying to promote inclusivity and welcoming, so the program is going to have something to deal with that. And we have all summer to decide of what this new tradition is going to be. We're also, you know, taking as many ideas as we can get.
Looks like students will have to wait and see what's in store for the next tradition. Who knows? But the class of 2013 might be in for a big surprise. Reporting up on Mount Clef, Heather Ford, CLU News.
The rocks aren't the only things changing on campus next year. CLU is looking into having online classes to accommodate for the increase in student population.
With more on the story, here's Carissa.
Hi, I'm Carissa Sherrill, and today we're here to talk with Sia DiMartino and Cynthia Grether about online learning resources. Sia, can you explain to me a little bit about the online learning resource classes, and are new classes going to be offered? Does CLU offer online classes already now?
Yes, through the Business School of Management, there are already online classes. Also, ADEP, the Adult Learning Program, offers hybrid and online classes. As for future classes, we are currently working that out.
And do you feel that teachers would prefer a classroom setting over online classes for students? Do they feel maybe that they would benefit more from a classroom setting?
I think there's a mix. I think there's faculty here who are interested in experimentation and pushing. There's some research that hybrid classes in particular, half online, half in the class, are really effective and can be very fast, help students learn things even faster than totally face-to-face traditional classrooms. It's hard to develop a sense of community, and community is so important here at Cal Lutheran. There's definitely also some ability to experiment and continue to do more online things in the future.
Cindy, can you tell us a little bit about what the online MBA courses, like how they work?
Well, we have a program, an MBA in financial planning. And with this program, we have an online, totally online curriculum. And students are able to take a course or several courses in a term, and the terms are 8 weeks long. And on each week, they have assignments and projects and things to do on each week assigned weekly. So they stay on task.
Part of the
online courses is a live chat. The live chat is once a week. It lasts about an hour and a half. And it's not a lecture. At that point in time, students are interacting. So they're able to raise their hand in the classroom. They're able to use their microphone.
Do you feel that online MBA courses are just as effective as classroom setting MBA courses?
I do. I really do. In fact, in some ways, I think our online classes are stronger than the on-campus classes. And it's part of it is that it's a continuous learning.
I'm Carissa Sherrill. Back to you guys in the studio.
One tradition that has stuck around on campus is the Mr. Kingsman contest.
This year was not a disappointment. The theater was packed with students supporting their Kingsman.
To tell us more about the event, we turned the camera to Anna.
Hi, I'm Anna McCree, and I'm standing in front of the Prius Brandt Forum where the 2013 Mr. Kingsman pageant was held. I went inside and talked to some of the contestants to see how nervous they really were before the show. Let's hear what they had to say.
My name is Jacob Garcia, and I will be performing a dance routine.
So what are you most excited for tonight?
For tonight, it'll be basically the talent portion.
My name is Andre Andoyan. It is my first year in Mr. Kingsman, and tonight I am Simba from The Lion King. I'm just excited for the energy. You know, I feel like being backstage with all the guys is a lot of fun. It's a great group of guys who are doing it. And so I think it's just going to be a really cool event. It's going to be just all about having fun and enjoying the night and trying to put on a good show for everybody who shows up.
This year's pageant was Disney-themed and directed by sophomore Allie Ruggles. All of the contestants were required to learn a choreographed dance as well as perform their own talent and answer an onstage question. Instead of a panel of judges like a normal pageant, the audiences sent in their votes via text message. At the end of the night, it was Harrison Sands that was crowned Mr. Kingsman 2013.
Tell me what your favorite part about Mr. Kingsman has been.
It's definitely been hanging out with all the guys, doing the group stuff. It's a lot of fun. I know all of them, and it's really fun to just kind of interact and mess around and learn a fun dance, I guess.
That was the 2013 Mr. Kingsman pageant. I'm Anna McCree. Until next year, back to you in the studio.
Earlier this week, the CLU choir came back from a tour in Denver.
They concluded their tour on campus last Tuesday. Camille is on location to tell us more about the tour.
I'm Camille Adair, here live at the California Lutheran University Chapel, where the CLU choir is expected to do their last performance as a conclusion of their spring tour. The California Lutheran University Choir, under direction of conductor Dr. Wyatt Morton, are dedicated to performing works that represent the university's Lutheran heritage and also embraces innovative new music, as well as music expressing a multicultural perspective. The members of the choir are carefully selected by audition. While several are music majors, the ensemble reflects the diverse interests and disciplines of the CLU student body. One of the perks of being a part of the choir is that they are invited to travel and tour certain locations to perform every year. The CLU Choir has performed in places such as London, Sweden, Norway, Italy, and recently they were able to perform at the prestigious Carnegie Hall in New York City. This year, the choir successfully toured Colorado, performing each day of their 7-day tour. This performance back at the CLU Chapel is the last of the year for the choir, and it's the conclusion of this year's tour.
Hi, I'm here in the CLU Chapel with Uriel Najera, and he is a member of the CLU Choir. Uriel, how do you think you did tonight?
I think we did really good. I mean, we've had all week to prepare, so.
I heard you went on the choir tour. How was that?
Oh, it was beautiful. Colorado is just a beautiful place, although it was a little bit cold.
What songs did you sing?
Oh, we sang many of songs. I don't know if you guys saw our extensive program, but songs of all genres, be it gospel or classical choir music.
What stop was your favorite in the Colorado tour?
I think my favorite stop had to be the U.S. Air Force, except I was kind of sad because all the men weren't there.
Oh no! Hi again, I'm here in the CLU Chapel with Gustavo Youngberg, another member of the CLU Choir. So I hear that you didn't go on tour, so how was it rejoining the choir back on this performance?
It was a lot different. I haven't heard them for a week and they've been singing a lot, so they sounded a lot stronger, you know, more confident. It's cool.
How do you think you guys did tonight?
I think it was really good. I think we sang very well, and I rather enjoyed it myself, so it was cool.
Do you think you'll join choir again next year?
Most definitely.
Okay. Hi, I'm here in the CLU Chapel with Dr. Morton. He is the conductor for the CLU Choir. Dr. Morton, how proud are you of your CLU Choir right now?
Really proud. They've really perform well and have a lot of fun, as you can see, but it all comes out of a lot of hard work. So we've been working a lot of hours, hundreds of hours, so I really feel like it paid off and it was a nice concert.
How was the turnout in Colorado? Was it all good?
It was great. We had good concerts, sang in some nice places. The weather was a little cold. It was 9 degrees and snowing when we landed, but other than that, it's a great trip, but always good to be back in Southern California.
Do you think you're going to come back to conduct one more year again?
Oh yes, I'll be back.
Okay, perfect.
Congratulations to the choir. Back to you in the studio.
In sports news, Kingsman baseball beat Caltech on their March 30th game.
The Kingsmen crushed the Beavers in a 17-0 victory.
Here's Michael with more on the game.
We're here with Tyler Hebda and Nico De La Valle after the Kingsmen defeated the Claremont Mudscripts Stags. You guys swept this series today. Tyler, you got the start on the hill in the first game. You went 6 2/3 innings. Can you talk a little bit about your performance?
I was just trying to get ahead of guys and because I knew they were going to get themselves out. That's how Jake pitched yesterday, and I knew I could do the same thing today.
And Nico, you had a good day at the plate. You were 6 for 9. You drove in 4 runs and scored 3 times. Talk a little bit about your at-bats.
I'm just sticking to my approach, what we've been working on all season, just owning the outside, reacting to inside pitches, and just kept doing what I've been doing all season along with the rest of the team.
And you guys are in first place in the SCIAC. Every game's a big game, every series is a big series as you're winding down the SCIAC regular season before the round robin. Can you talk about how these games you use to your advantage moving forward?
We just want to win these games, hopefully sweep both teams. It would be big for us. We'll keep staying first and keep staying first for the whole time.
Yeah, just keep doing what we're doing. It's been working now. Why change anything? So.
Great. Thank you. Congratulations. We're here with Trevor Coons, who broke the school record for career doubles today. Trevor, do you know going into today that you are 2 doubles away from that record?
On Wednesday, actually, I knew I was coming up close before the season. I knew I needed around 12, 13. Then after Arizona, I knew I was getting close, and I checked on Wednesday. I knew I needed 4. Then I hit 2 yesterday. And then I kind of forgot that I had one earlier on my last at-bat. And so I was trying to drive him in, bases loaded. So it was a good time for it. And I didn't really change my approach, really. I mean, I guess I've always hit doubles. I'm not a power guy. I live in the gaps. So just kind of trying to get the barrel and the ball on it. Worked out well. It wasn't the hardest double I've ever hit in my life, but worked out well.
And you and both you and your teammate Nick Bogan are pretty close to the hits records as well. Do you guys keep that in the back of your mind during the season, or do you just again keep the same approach and just whatever happens happens?
I mean, I wouldn't say. I just know we're aware of it. Bugs and I, we've been great friends, great teammates ever since freshman year. We kind of made a pact earlier that in our freshman year that we were gonna, try and get some, just try and leave our mark on the program. And so far we have, and I wouldn't say we stress about it, but we're both having fairly decent seasons and just working out well for the both of us. But we're definitely aware of it and what a great accomplishment it would be.
Spring is finally here with students back from break and ready to finish up the last couple months of school.
We had Dom ask students what they did over spring break.
I'm on the campus of Cal Lutheran University interviewing students about what they did over spring break. I don't know about you guys, but I had a great spring break. Let's see what they had to say.
Yes, I did. I went to London and Paris.
And what did you do in London and Paris?
In Paris, we saw the Eiffel Tower. And in London, we went and saw like Big Ben and the Eye and that whole area. Walked around a lot, went to a lot of bars. I'm not gonna say that. Okay.
Cut my hair off, so that was interesting.
How much hair did you cut off?
I cut 13 inches off, so that was a lot for me.
Wow.
Big change.
I did, and then right after that, we went to Havasu. We drove down for about 2 or 3 days, and we stayed at some little rinky-dink hotel, but we had fun out on the water. We got a boat and enjoyed ourselves.
Yeah, I went to a Shania Twain concert.
How was that?
It was really awesome. She had 2 different horses on stage, flew in on a motorcycle. It was pretty great.
So we took a road trip up to Washington, but we made a quick stop in the Bay Area, had to check out the scenes, of course. Went to the Lakers Warriors game, which was really, really fun. Then after that, once we made our way to Washington, we were there, went to go visit some former CLU friends who were in a frat up there, and it was really fun.
I heard that you got serenaded?
Yes, we got serenaded by 30 sorority girls, and we found out after that they were all freshmen, so that was very appealing.
A bunch of students did a bunch of different things over spring break. What did you guys do back in the studio?
Thanks, Dom. I had a relaxing week of spending time with my family and friends.
Me too.
Yeah.
That's all for this week's news.
Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next week.